Hari Om students, welcome back to the next topic. As I told in the previous class, living things have some of the characteristics like living things can move, living things can grow, living things can breathe, living things can feel, and living things can reproduce also. Let's see the first characteristic, movement. All living things need the ability to move. Why living things can move? What is the reason? Living things can move in search of food. For example, observe in the picture. A girl walking. Yes, a girl walking along with the girl, dog also walking. Now, the girl is a living thing or non-living thing? Living thing, because moving, it shows movement. Even dog also, these two are living things. Let's see that animals move in many ways. Even plants move, such as a flower's bud open into a flower. Sunflower turns towards sunlight. Different animals have different organs for movement, like fish uses fins and tails to move. Horse, cow, and some of the animals will use their limbs to move. The animals have four limbs, two hind limbs and two forelimbs. So total four limbs helps to move the animals. Birds. Some of the birds can walk and some of the birds can fly. With the help of feet can walk the birds, and with the help of the wings, birds can fly. Human beings use two legs to walk. Like that, each and every animal or living thing, it shows their movement in different ways. Let's see. I said already plants also will show the movement. This is touch me not plant. Touch me not plant. This plant, when we touches it, it close. See how it is closing? Closing the leaves. Now after some time, it open it. Slowly it will open it. So this, the name of this plant, touch me not plant. It has another name. We should call it as a mimosa plant also. And I said already sunflower also, it shows the movement. So it always faces towards the sun. These two plants will show the movement. So living things also will show the movement. Even plants also will show the movement. Let's observe the following pictures carefully. As I told, all living things will show the movement. Even animals also will show the movement. Let's observe the first picture, fish. Fishes are there in the aquarium. So, fish swims in water with the help of fins and tails. And this is the fin. And this is the tail. With the help of these two organs, fish can swim in water. Let's see the second picture. Butterflies. Butterflies flies on flower with the help of their wings. With the help of their wings, flies on flowers. Even birds also will fly with the help of the wings. So why it is flies on the flower only? Because to get their food. So in flowers, liquid will be presented. That liquid we should call as nectar. So the butterflies will suck nectar from flowers. Let's observe the third picture. Frog. Frog can live in the water as well as on the land also. In the water, it will swim with the help of the webbed feet. This is the webbed feet. So frogs can swim in water with the help of webbed feet, as well as on the land it leaps on the ground. Let us observe the fourth picture. People walk on the road with the help of the legs. So already I said human being have two legs. With the help of the two legs can walk. Let's see the second characteristics. Living things need food. All living things need food to grow and to get energy to do their works. All living things like plants, animals, birds, insects, each and every living thing need food to grow and to get energy also. Animals get their food from plants and other sources. Most plants make their own food with the help of water, air and sunlight. Plants won't depend on other things. Plants can make their own food. So where do plants prepare the food? Plants prepare the food in the leaf. Observe the first picture. Plants make their own food with the help of water and air and sunlight. Let's see that. Observe the picture. So water and minerals are getting from the soil. So who is taking here? The roots are taking this water and minerals from the soil, and through the stem it will send to the leaf. The air, that means carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is taken by the tiny holes which are present underside of the leaf. We should call as stomata. This stomata will absorb the carbon dioxide. In the presence of sunlight, with the help of these two things, plants can prepare the food, their food in the leaf. And as well as along with the food, it will release oxygen also. Most of the animals get their food from, I said already, get their food from plants and other animals. Let us observe the second picture. We can see different kinds of food items here. Yes, like animal foods, rice, and different kinds of vegetables. We can observe in the pictures. Some of the vegetables, fruits, and grains we are getting from the plants, and like milk and milk products and meat, eggs, these such kind of foods are getting from animals. Let's see the third characteristics of living things. Living things grow. All living things can grow with the help of food. Like a human baby grows into an adult. Let's observe the picture once. A small baby onwards grows into an adult stage. See, a small baby onwards it will grows into an adult. Even animals also. A small baby onwards it is growing into an adult. Even some of the animals will give directly birth, and some of the animals will lay eggs. Like birds, insects will lay eggs, and other animals will give directly birth. What about plants? Plants can reproduce? Yes, plants can reproduce in many ways. Some of the plants can reproduce by the seeds, and some of the plants reproduce by the stem, and some of the plants reproduce by the leaves, and some of the plants will reproduce by the flowers. Like that, each and every part of a plant in different plants can reproduce. Let's see, a small seed onwards it is growing into a big tree. So like that, even plants also will grow. Now let's see the fourth characteristic. living things feel. All living things will feel. Humans and animals can feel pain, love, cry, etc. So living things react to change around them and within them also. We react to touch, light, heat, cold, and sound, as do other living things. So yes, real. Let's see that our sense of feel will be easy in our fingertips. So when we touches anything or any objects, we can easily identify those things. Yes, the sense of touch will be easy in our fingertips. These are the fingertips. When we close the eyes and we can touch the things, even though we can find that object or things. So the sense of feel is in our fingertips. Next, plants also have that feelings. Did you observe that tree can cry or laugh or any it is feeling any pain? No, only some of the plants will feel. I said already, the touch me not plant have the sense of touch. When we touches it, it will open as well as it will shows the movement also. So the mimosa plant will show the movement. So all living things can feel, and especially animals have the special sense organs to feel around us. So how many sense organs do they have? So they have 5 sense organs: eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. With the help of these 5 sense organs, animals can feel. Now let's see the 5th characteristic of living things. Living things breathe. All living things will breathe. They have the special respiratory organs. With the help of those organs, living things can breathe. How? For example, see, we are taking air and releasing out also. So we are taking breath. So human beings will breathe. How? With the help of lungs. Let's observe the picture. With the help of lungs, human being will breathe. So remaining animals also have the respiratory organs. So each and every animal have different types of respiratory organs. For example, let's see the picture. Fish will breathe through the gills. How? Let's see that. This is the gill. So fish is taking air through mouth, and through the gills it will release it out. So exhaling, inhaling. So inhaling is through the mouth and exhaling is through gills. So fish is taking in air through the mouth and it will release through the gills. So this organ, the special organ in respiratory organ in fish is gills. Let's see that insects. Insects have the special features. Both the sides, it has a tiny holes presented. With the help of these tiny holes, insects will breathe. These tiny holes we should call as air holes. So insects will breathe through air holes. Like that, each and every animal have special breathing organs to breathe. What about plants? Plants have nose to breathe? No. Plants will breathe through the leaves. How? So in the leaves, the underside of the leaf, it has a tiny holes. That holes we should call as stomata. So through the stomata, plants taking air. See, observe the pictures. We can't see stomata with our naked eye. We can see only in microscope. See, this is the opening stomata and this is closing. So when it is opening, it is taking carbon dioxide, and when it is closing, it is exhaling oxygen. Exhaling means releasing out. So animals have different organs to breathe, and even plants also will breathe through the stomata. Last characteristic of living things reproduce. Most of the percent all the living things can reproduce. What is mean by reproduction or reproduce? What is the meaning of reproduction? The process of producing young ones or same kind, we should call as reproduction. The producing babies or increasing their number. So that process we should call as reproduction. Most of the percent all living things can reproduce. For example, a human being. Human being will give directly birth to their young ones. Birds will lay eggs and hatch out eggs. And other animals also will give directly birth to their young ones. What about plants? Plants also will reproduce by the different parts of a plant. Most of the percent plants will reproduce by the seeds. And some of the plants only will reproduce by the other parts of a plant. For example, rose. Rose will reproduce by the stem cutting method. Yes, rose plant have any seeds? No, only flowers. So that's why some of the parts of a plant will reproduce. Let us observe the picture. See, the first a seed will grow into a plant. So most of the percent plants will reproduce by the seeds. Let us observe second picture. Animal. This is a dog. Dog will give birth to their puppies. So like that, all animals can reproduce by the two methods, that is egg laying method, and another method is giving directly birth. Plants will reproduce by the seeds. Let me summarize the point what we have discussed now. So we discussed all the characteristics of living things like movement, growth, feel, and food, and reproduction also. Now I have given one small exercise or assignment. It's like a worksheet. So you have to complete this worksheet. And I have given direction also, and as well as I have given some of the things in the box. You have to fill up these things in the correct columns. And direction, what is a living thing? Think about the characteristics of a living thing. Sort the living things and non-living things into the proper columns. Discuss why you sorted the way you did. And revise all the points, and you should complete this worksheet. Hurry up.